the information.
Okay, so starting with introduction. First of all, I'd like to thank the organizer for kindly inviting me to this wonderful workshop. So today, in this talk, I'd like to talk about something on TTbar information. So before going into the details, I'd like to give an overview of my talk. So first of all, I'd like to explain what is TTbar information, especially so we would like to consider TTbar information of the major kind of field theory. So we will consider two major kinds of theory for me, and we will consider the major one. And TTbar means a composite operator composed of energy momentum tensors, and so T means energy momentum tensor, okay? So TTbar is a composite operator. So I would like to explain the statement, gravitational perturbations in the first specific gravity can be regarded as TTbar information of the major quantum field theory. So this is the main statement in this talk. And JT is an abbreviation of Jacket Tidal Point, and the JT gravity is a kind of electron gravity in this dimension. So anyway, so this statement is very interesting, and this was shown by Kosky et al. In this paper. So the main subject in this talk is to consider the generalizations of this work from dark space-time and couple spaces, like the anti-Yoshida space or the Yoshida space. So the strategy is quite simple. So anyway, so this is part of my talk. So first of all, I'd like to give some reviews on some relevant aspects of TTbar information of three-dimensional quantum field theories by using 10 slides. So then, I'd like to discuss gravitational perturbations in the JT gravities as TTbar information of three-dimensional quantum field theories. Okay, so then, let me explain about some relevant aspects of TTbar information of three-dimensional quantum field theories. So if you are interested in this subject, please take a look. It's a nice review by Chiang. So this is very concise and very nice review on TTbar information. Okay, so before going to the details, so let me make some setup for notation and transparency. So we will consider three-dimensional quantum field theories with global energy momentum tensor, TMU. So this is quite a standard setup. And so we would like to consider determinant operators funded by this one. So T and T bar are the usual definitions. TTbar component of energy momentum tensor and TTbar component of energy momentum tensor. So T and T bar are usually defined. And so now we are interested in a general quantum field theory. So the first part of the energy momentum tensor does not vanish. So theta corresponds to the first part of the energy momentum tensor and theta is also unique. So this operator is determinant operator, and so there is a deviation from TTbar, but this operator is conventionally called the TTbar operator. Okay, so these operators have really nice properties, and anyway, this operator is redefined as a complex operator in two dimensions. So this nice property was discovered by Sasha Tamoshi in 2004. So and
is it positive negative operator?
This is the subject in the next talk, and so we should be careful with that point. Okay, so anyway, so let me explain about a nice property of TTbar definition one more. So anyway, so TTbar operator has a nice property, a factorization of expectation value of TTbar operators. So the expectation value of TTbar operator is factorized like this. So this factorization was shown by such a number of people. So this factorization is valid for stationary states, like energy eigenstates of California, under the simple assumptions.
So is that just the expectation value or matrix element?
Expectation value, so not limited to what you can do.
It's not form factor. So expectation value with respect to the particle state.
Particle state. Actually, the particle states are stationary states, right?
No, that relation is valid even for the matrix element or just the vacuum expectation value.
I'm sure for form factors.
Mm-hmm. What is the beginning of the Smirnoff and Termalogic?
So this is the form factor.
So that relation is valid also for form
factors? I think so, yeah, probably. So this factorization is independent. Maybe independent of the form factor, but anyway, yeah.
Exactly.
So this optimization is valid under some mild assumptions. So without using gradient limit or using supersymmetry, so this optimization is valid. So this is quite strong property. And the first two assumptions are quite mild. These are the symmetry assumptions, global translation invariance and rotational invariance, and global translation invariance. And the third one is a bit stronger. So this is the theoretic case of this one direction for which one can take this limit. So in order to show this optimization, we are doing the perfect composition. So that's why, so at least one direction should be immediately drawn. So then, so by assuming the second one and third one, the three-dimensional base space is limited to infinite plane or immediately drawn cylinder. So this is a very important point. And the post conditions may be redundant, but so this was imposed in order to make definitions of digital operators unambiguous. Okay, so then, so you have to start applications of these factorizations. So let's consider a quantum field is defined on an infinitely long cylinder. So then, so the intersection value of P and T bar does not vanish. And so then.
So it does, you showed that. So the relation is valuable for any n.
Yes. So anyway, so in this paper, so such as Amoshitov evaluated the differentiation value of digital operators like this by using etiquette. So then, so you can get this expression. And so then, by using the typical meaning of the stress tensors used by this one, so we can express this differentiation value in terms of energy and momentum. So this was the result obtained in this paper. Okay, so this is a nice properties of factorization and its applications. And so then, let me explain what TTbar definition is. So let's assume the set of three-dimensional quantum field theories described by Lagrange. So consider a trajectory in the field theory space parameterized by constant alpha. And genomes are Lagrange at each point of the trajectory by a alpha. Okay? So then, we can consider a plot for theories on the trajectory figured by the TTbar operators like this. So this is a defining relation of TTbar plot. So this TTbar plot is figured by this uniform perturbations. So here we knew has a mass dimension 4. So this coupling constant should be infinitesimal, and this has a dimension of n square. Okay, so this is the definition of TTbar plot. So on the right, it makes some notes here. So this TTbar plot is not the usual RG plot. So if you want to consider the RG type plot by using this dimensional operators, so we will usually consider this type of definition. But this definition is defined from this TTbar plot. So this TTbar plot is defined from the usual RG plot. And so this TTbar plot gives rise to a one parameter family of two-dimensional quantum field theories. It has a common alpha, so alpha may be finite, but the alpha should be infinitesimal. Okay, so and the unfold theory, may be a general two-dimensional quantum field theories. Of course, this may be a formal field theories. So then, IR fixed points appear here, and so we can consider relevant transmissions around IR fixed point like this. Okay, so then, in fact, TTbar deformation is governed by a simple differential equation. So this is the TTbar equations proposed by Sibiru and Zamolchikov and Roberto Tadero and TTbar operators independently. So anyway, so this four equation is equivalent to this fine equation of TTbar problem. So this flow equation was proposed as an operator equation at quantum level, but at least so far, classical aspects of this equation have been well studied. So in the following, we will see three classical aspects of this TTbar equation. So I'd like to explain TTbar modular function and TTbar modular spectrum, according to the JTbar analysis. And here, we will not discuss quantum aspects of the TTbar flow equation, but for some argument on quantum aspects. See a nice paper by Rosenhaus and his collaborators, and here the next book by Harlan. So he's going to discuss about cell positivity of TTbar formations. So Yama-san asked. Okay, so anyway, so we will concentrate on the classical aspects of TTbar formation in the problem. So
is there any criteria other than the positivity that you select this particular? There are tons of irrelevant numbers. Why do you consider this?
I'm not sure, but anyway, so integrability may be useful so to control the perturbation structures or something. And so anyway, so the renormalizations can be controlled, but the subjectivity cannot be controlled probably. And so, but okay, so anyway, so that point is discussed to this slide. And
your renormalization goes in the opposite direction rather than the normalization.
But still can be controlled. Yeah, because TTbar deformation is integral deformation. And okay, so anyway, so let me finish explanation of this slide. So actually the context of this slide is closely related to your question. And so
so there are so many irrelevant operators.
Yes.
And TTbar is just one of them. And in this IR region, all these irrelevant operators contribute almost nothing. So in flow equation, if you stick to TTbar flow direction, still there could be contribution from other
kind
of fine tuning problem. How can you restrict other very very negligible coefficients of other iterators?
But actually, so the from the viewpoint of integrability, so the TTbar deformations can only be
considering TTbar deformation of integral model, right? You are considering deformation of the actually compound, IR compound. So in that case, how do you control of the effect of the other irrelevant?
Probably so perturbability may be useful to control the perturbation.
Right.
And so
if it's not integral, how do you know? Your theory is need not be integral.
No. So if you consider the TTbar deformation of the mass scalar.
That's true.
Yeah, of course, so the integrality depends on the original theory. But if you start from the non-integral theories, so integrality is not preserved, and so probably perturbation can be controlled. But if you start from free mass scalar or integral model, so we can control perturbation.
So Yakuza will be this.
Yes. Okay, so anyway, so this is a remarkable result on TTbar deformation. So this is the famous result. So as an example, let's consider TTbar deformations over free mass scalar. So then the deformed theory is described by number of functions with static pitch. So this is a very famous statement on TTbar deformations. So here, let me show you a simple derivation of the number of actions by starting from this answer. So f of x is an unknown function here, so we need this initial condition. So then, by putting these answers into the definitions of the energy momentum tensors, so then we will get these quantities. So then, by taking a derivative in terms of alpha, so we will get this one. So then, by putting these expressions into the TTbar equation, we can get this simple differential equation. Of course, it is very easy to solve these differential equations by using mathematical, for example. So then, this is the solution. So small x is defined by this one, and so by putting this expression here, so we can get this Lagrangian Lagrangian for actually alpha. So this is nothing but the number of options in static pH. So this static pH is quite important. So if without fixing pH conditions, energy momentum tensor for number of options is zero. So we can consider the TTbar deformation. But by taking the static pH, energy momentum tensor is non-zero. And so we can consider TTbar deformations for number of options. And interestingly, so this deformation parameter has a dimension squared. And this deformation parameter alpha can be regarded as alpha prime in swing separation. So this is quite an interesting coincidence. So this is a random result.
It's equal
to zero. C is an integration constant. So this is a differential equation, and so we will get the integration constant. And so we need to fix this constant. just a normalization of IP.
Okay, so yeah, probably it could be instructive to see the expanded form of the non-quotal actions. So then you can compare this non-quotal action with the algebra type interpretation. So by expanding this non-quotal action, so then we will get a unique number of relevant operators, as you said. So these algebra operators can be interpreted as very complicated relevant perturbations around the IRPX point. Okay, but then, so this solution is quite analogous perturbation, but the expansion in the Hitchboldo model. Of course, in the case of the Hitchboldo model, so this is the relevant perturbations, but we will get the huge number of terms, but the normalizations can be controlled by using Univ. So, the possibilities, so these many independent operators may be controlled by using integral bit. But of course, we need to be careful for other issues, like positivity or something. But the object for perturbation may be controlled by integral bits if we start from integral of 7. Okay, so then let me explain about the TTbar deformed spectrum. So let's evaluate the TTbar equation itself by using the excited state and gate. So then, so the TTbar equation is evaluated by this. So then, the right-hand side has been evaluated already by such as a logical in 2004. So then, so this equation is given into this forcing visit Vargas equation. So this Vargas equation controls the full spectrum. So this is an interesting property. So by solving this Vargas equation analytically, the default spectrum is computed itself. So, but, so in order to solve this differential equation, we need to set the initial conditions for this differential equation. So one has to know the original spectrum EN for the uniform theory. So the uniform theory should be homomorphic field theory or integral or quantum field theory. So then we can know the original data to solve this differential equation. So, and even if the original spectrum is unknown, the deformed effect itself can be examined by solving this differential equation. So, in this sense, this TTbar deformation is called integral deformation. And but in particular, in the case of integral quantum field theory, so this is really an integral deformation in the usual sense. Actually, so this TTbar deformation is a relevant perturbation, so the IR information is not changed. So the whole structure is not changed. So the response mix, which is extra CDD factor only. So the optimization of the response mix is preserved under TTbar deformation. So in this sense, TTbar deformation is an integral deformation for the quantum integrability. Okay, so then, so let's consider an example of TTbar deformation of a few series on a cylinder. So then, so you may start from this usual data, primary state in conformal field theory, so energy and energy momentum. So then, by using this data as input, so we can solve the Vargas equation, and this is the resulting form of the deformed spectrum. So now, small d is the deformation parameter, and so this is the damage recombination of the deformation parameter alpha. So L is the diode. So this is a famous example of the TTbar deformed spectrum in conformal field theory. And by using these energies, so we can compute the associated entropies by using Cauchy formula. And these deformed spectrum and entropy were very useful to look for holographic inverse of TTbar deformed conformal field theory. And so then, so depending on the signatures of the deformation parameters, two types of gravity curves were proposed. So for the positive sign of alpha, so algebra type solutions from reducing theory to analytical spin time are proposed by Bell and Barrow. And for negative sign, so the gravity curve should be described as a cutoff radius geometry. So this cutoff radius geometry should be very famous for entanglement entropy. So yeah, probably so a lot of people are working on these holographic integrals or TTbar deformed conformal field.
Where is negative
So the signature will be one perturbation and should be crucial for the fitting. So if you consider the 5 to 6 perturbation for the 5 to 7 EV 4 dimensions, so then the boundedness of the classical potential depends on the signatures of the one perturbation, right? So that's why so the signature of the information parameter is crucial for the fitting.
Excuse me, so does the signature, so I assume that if you have signature differences, the levels can actually cross each other, right? The deform energy levels.
The deform energy level, yeah, of course, yeah. So, and so we should be careful for these loop structures. So that's why, so the, there should, okay, so we should consider the upper limit for the entropy YNC, and so then we need to consider the cutoff radius.
Okay.
And so this is the origin of the cutoff of the geometry. Okay, so anyway, so I will not discuss the probability well anymore. But anyway, so these are really fascinating topics, and a lot of people are working on these subjects. Okay, so then let me explain why TTbar deformation is so interesting. So at this over, we have presented classical aspects of TTbar flow, and the resulting spectrum. So the resulting Bohr spectrum would be quite analogous to the random level. So actually, in my explanations so far, so we do it with the TTbar equation at classical level in theory, but so we use the quantum energies as an input. So this situation is quite similar to lambda level. So quantum energy level is formed by having a classical magnetic field. So that's why so this situation is quite analogous to lambda level. In the case of TTbar equations, classical gravity is tangent instead of magnetic field. In fact, by performing a field-dependent Fourier transformations, TTbar deformations can be undone while the base space is deformed with the classical magnetic perturbations. Okay, so this is just an analysis. I'm not sure about the university. Anyway, so this is just so anyway, so this situation is quite similar to cyber-missing map. So this is something like a higher version of cyber-missing map. And so after the Fourier transformation are considered by Kali and Gorski and Kateo. And so anyway, so I can say that the TTbar deformation is closely related to the classical perturbation of the metric in base space. So this is a very interesting point. So that's why so we'd like to consider the TTbar gravities in the TTbar deformation. Actually, so this statement is ensured from the TTbar gravities from the behind. And this is an ambitious motive to consider TTbar deformations. So if the TTbar flow equations can be understood at quantum level fully, clue to quantum gravities may be captured. So this is the external motivation to consider TTbar deformation. Okay, so anyway, so in my talk, so the analysis is entirely at classical level. And okay, so I still have screens or something, and so I'd like to briefly explain about my results on gravitational perturbations. Okay, so this part is based on these papers, including a short review by Yoshida. So here, we are interested in two-dimensional Gravitational gravities, including modern fields. So this is the classical actions of two-dimensional Gravitational gravities. So this is the metric, and pi is here, and psi is the modern field of two-dimensional gravity. So this is the two-dimensional Gravitational gravity action. So this action is sometimes called JD gravity. So this action contains a Gravitational potential. And so this potential will not be fixed for a while. And this is a matter action. And so matter action contains echo of pi in general, but this is a little coupling to matter. But for simplicity, echo of pi is set to 1. And kappa is usually mentioned of Newton constant. This is Newton constant. And so then we can derive the classical equation of motion. And okay, so this is the explanation of the setup. And so we are interested in the gravitational perturbation and the classical solutions. And we will find. So we will not fix classical solutions explicitly. So keep it in general. Okay, so then the functions can be expanded like this. So zero order term and first order term and second order term. And zero order term corresponds to classical energy, and first order term of the zero gravity should vanish by using the equation of motion. So then the second order part can be evaluated like this. So this is the zero gravity part, and the matter part can be evaluated like this. So this motion in the energy momentum tensor is less than 1. So then, so the actions can be written into this form. So the first part is the matter action on the undeformed pattern. So this is, this may be regarded as undeformed theory. So then, so the remaining part may be regarded as the conditions for this part. So my statement is that, so this next part may be regarded as a typical condition for this part. Okay, so this part can be used in other form by using this answer. So this answer means that the energy fluctuation in Q should be written in terms of energy momentum tensor like this. So this answer was proposed by Kosky in the first step time, and which is a four-layer generalization of Kosky's answers. So then, by using these answers and equations of motions, we can derive the deformation part like this. So this is a starting expression. So in the case of the cloud specific gravity, so the electron potential is just a constant. So then this part drops and this part becomes constant, and so this part may be regarded as a typical deformation. Okay, so this is the Kyoto result obtained in the cloud specific gravity. So we'd like to consider more general cases by looking for appropriate electron potential or something. So, and it is still necessary to solve the equations of motions for the electron fluctuation sigma. So actually, so in both these papers, the existence of solutions for sigma was proven, but the explicit solution was not obtained, but we tried. So this is the explicit expression of sigma, but we have no time, and so I will skip the explanation for the detail of this solution. But so in fact, in the case of the block space JT gravity, the metric perturbations can be seen as TTbar deformations, and in other words, any TTbar deformation can also be seen as a gravitational perturbation. So in this sense, Dvorsky's statement is very strong and very interesting. So anyway, so TTbar deformation is almost equivalent to the perturbations depicted here. And this is the point. So how about in more general JT gravity? So in general, the metric perturbations cannot be seen as TTbar deformations because W prime of the electron potential appears, and that is proportional to sigma. And so the deformation part, so the second order fluctuation may not be regarded as TTbar deformation in general. So our statement here is the following. So let's look for appropriate electron potential U of pi. And so then, solve the equations of motion for the electron fluctuation sigma, while the metric answer is the same. So this is our solution. So in the following, we'd like to consider a famous example, Alperin-Polchinski model. So this is called AP model. So AP model contains a possible constant term here. So L is the curvature radius, and we'd like to consider here. This electron potential plus conformal matter conditions for the matter sector. So then, so this model has a most general vacuum solution. So this was obtained by Pancheri and Poshinsky. So the metric is given by the usual ABF2, and this is the electron solutions, so ABC. So this contains the constant parameter ABC. So this is a realization of SL2 symmetry of the metric in the field. Okay, so then we have fixed the expressions of the gravitational fluctuation sigma explicitly. So by taking this answer, this n is a scalar function, and this scalar function is a local function given by these quantities. So anyway, so this is a very complicated, but anyway, so we can derive the explicit expressions of gravitational fluctuations like this. And I'd like to make some remarks for the electron fluctuation sigma. So this sigma satisfies this simple differential equation. So this is nothing but the usual previous pseudo function. And usually, so we like to solve these differential equations by using the gradient power polynomial or hypergeometric functions. But these are the local solutions. But we have derived the local solutions for this simple differential equation. So in other words, so we found the more trivial local solutions for this differential equation. And so these solutions may play an important role in the context of a shift bound. So probability that this solution has a physical meaning in the context of probability. And note here that we have assumed the optimal matters, so TTbar prototype interpretation is not applicable. So in general, so compulsory artwork, the optimal symmetry is broken. But the TTbar equation should be defined for arbitrary value of constant parameter alpha. But we have imposed open water conditions, and so we cannot take arbitrary value of alpha. So we should consider this perturbation should be a perturbation around alpha equals zero. So we should consider the algebra type interpretations in electrically. So we try to avoid the open matter conditions if possible. So we need some trial that I will speak this part. So I have no time now. So let me summarize my talk. So I have explained a relation between gravitational perturbation down to the individual dimensions of three-dimensional quantum field series. And in the first phase, it is gravity. So this statement is established by Boskiewicz. And in this talk, I have tried to consider generalizations of the Boskiewicz and in some specific right ranges. And in the EP model, the conformal matters and gravitational perturbations can be seen as individual deformations with the RG type interpretation. So we put a conformal matter condition, so this deformation may not be divided as a TTbar deformation, but we can consider TTbar deformations. And in other words, so we have explicitly derived exact solutions for linear perturbations around the AP model. And we got a non-trivial, non-local solution for sigma, and so it may be useful in the context of probability. And so output the following. So we have to consider the interpretation of the background electron changes in the fluctuations. So actually, the electron potential U of phi bar appears in the expression of second order action. So it depends on the space-time coordinate. So we need to consider the interpretation of that electron potential, and especially dependence on the space-time coordinate. And so I have skipped the last slide. So, but in order to resolve the conformal matter conditions, we need to consider the TTbar deformation of the three-dimensional quantum field series on curved space. So I think that it has not been very studied so far. So we would like to consider the TTbar deformation on a curved space. Okay, so I will finish. Thank you so much.
Questions? Comments?
So, is JT gravity classical?
Yes, so here, so we need JT gravity as a classical model.
So, is there generalization to higher dimension?
Yeah, so some people consider the higher dimensional generalizations. For example, these operators were considered for higher dimensional. So but so there should be a serious problem for realization of the TTbar operator itself. So that regularization dependence can be controlled only in two dimensions. And so apart from the regularization problem, we can consider the similar structures even in higher dimensions.